I feel like as a player, you never really want to respect someone so much. You need to not be afraid to make plays and be like, oh, I'm probably better than this guy. Because if you give someone too much respect, you're like, oh, he's better than me. I probably shouldn't try this. So, you know, you need to have the mindset of like, oh, this guy's garbage. I bet this is going to work on him. I think having, like, for lack of a better word, cocky mindset is way better to have.
Welcome back to week 11 of the North American LCS. We will see how Kiwi Kid's fearless attitude helps him and his team in just a few minutes. First, we want to check in with what you've been saying over at Twitter. Earlier, we asked you which NALCS player is the most innovative and why. Here's just a taste of the answers we've gotten in. At Random Stuff to Do. I do too. I think Lemon Nation is the most innovative player in NA because he brought out the Ashe Zyra lane and now the Corki Karma lane.
And how long is the Corki Karma lane going to last? Got to give some credit to Sneaky too. He's got to play all those 80 carries.
Yeah, he does.
Just because he has a notebook doesn't mean he's making the decisions.
There's always two parts to it. At Chalikoff says, I think Cloud9's High is the most innovative player in the league. He has a great champion pool. Bring him back. Soraka in the mid lane.
Yeah, that was actually the player we discussed when we were talking about the most innovative player. Some people would say that he plagiarizes solo queue, but he's the one who brings it into the LCS, so it's still
counts. He gives credit in his bibliography. As Xander de Ronde says, it's all in the name, Inoxvation. His niche top lane picks have been very entertaining to watch so far, with ups and downs.
Yeah, ups and downs. A lot of ups and downs.
Goodly
Sin play, though, for sure.
It's a roller coaster ride. Yeah. At Bradtastic, our last response. Bradtastic Craft. Sorry. Kobe is the most innovative player in the LCS. The flash for Odd One over the wall is too much.
Yeah, fantastic strategy there by Kobe in the ultra rapid fire future preview we had.
Yeah, it was pretty crazy. Thanks to everyone who wrote in with their great responses, but we're greedy and we want more. Send it to @LOLESports and use the hashtag LCS to join in on the conversation. And now without further ado, let's dive into our next game, Dignitas versus Team Coast. Jap, it's another matchup that's gone 3-0 so far, but Dig has this one in their favor.
Cruiser in particular has been very successful against Zion. Spartan, an average of 17.0 KDA in this matchup. And for a comparison, Cruiser's 2.4 against the rest of the league, which is incredibly potent for Team Coast because Coast relies so heavily on their solo lanes. Cruiser will be a problem, and they'll have to tackle him in order to take the win.
Right, now we can know that Coast is locked in for the sixth seed, but this game could give them a big confidence boost and an opportunity to work on their game.
Coast is going to have a tough fight tomorrow as well when they face Cloud9. You know, we saw Coast returning to the split push strategy, but they'll need the rest of the team to step up and help carry. Looking at the team, who really needs to step up the most, Nintendo in particular, has not had a big impact for his team, especially in this matchup. His overall KDA in the NALCS is 1.7, and his last three games against Dig in particular have been less than stellar as well. I mean, if he were able to make some big plays, I think it could really help Coast in their hunt to prepare for the playoffs and get some momentum, because Coast is such a momentum-based team.
They need it both, and all of these teams need it coming out of Super Week. So with that, we are going to check out the starting lineups and get into the game. On the blue side, it's Dignitas. In the top lane, it's Cruiser. Crumbs in the jungle, Golden Glue in the mid lane. I'm a cutie pie at 80 carry, and there's Kiwi Kid getting a close-up on support.
Yeah, and on the red side, it's going to be Team Coast. Sound Spartan top, jungle is Nintendo, mid is Shifter, Wiz Fusion on 80 carry, and Daydreamin' on support.
And this will actually be the first time Golden Glue gets the matchup against Shifter. He's already had quite a test with Bjergsen and High being some of the first few he had to play against, but this will be another one. Shifter is one of the mids that can actually hit up Bjergsen quite well.
Yeah, Golden Glue, as described by Crumbs and Kiwi Kid. Daydream is sad. Crumbs and Kiwi Kid went a little crazy in the last game, they said. He's excitable.
Yeah,
so to speak.
Didn't really understand what he was saying sometimes, but it worked.
The whole Dignitas team can be a little bit excitable sometimes. The Scar coaching also coming in pretty handy as well.
Yeah.
And for this matchup, obviously Dignitas is 3-0. And a lot of that just speaks to Coast's inability to beat higher seeded teams this year. They really have not been able to pull off their strategies against top of the LCS or even middle LCS caliber teams. And as they move towards the playoffs, even though Coast is locked in for that matchup against CLG, being able to win games against better teams is absolutely crucial for not getting relegated, because the loser of the playoffs will still end up getting relegated.
It's always good to keep yourself in the factor where it can be in any given day for that game and not just something that consistently, you know, is going to hit on the record.
Yeah, Cruiser Lee Sin.
Cruiser Lee Sin once again.
There's actually a really good comment on Reddit in the game thread after the Dignitas game. It was Dignitas They were trying to figure out, like, how did they Dignitas decide for Kruiser to play top lane Lee Sin? And it was something like Kiwi Kid being like, hey, Kruiser, don't you play Lee Sin? Kruiser said, yeah, I do. Locked it in. And then next was like, Dignitas wins the world championship. Because Kruiser, it's the champion that brought him into League of Legends.
Yep.
He was so good on it yesterday. It got picked away from him in an earlier matchup. And now he's picked it once again. Let's hope that goes top lane and this wasn't all for nothing.
What do you do when it looks like there's nothing to do? You go back to comfort. That's what he's going to be hitting up. Zion Spartan and Intendude X grabbing the bot lane right away for Coast in this one. Something that really also needs to be picked up for Coast. WizFusion has had a bit better of a performance coming out here, but the whole team needing to step up here in Super Week.
Yeah. He had a fairly ineffective Lucian against Team Solo Mid earlier today. Obviously, Dignitas coming into this game 1-0 on the day, whereas Team Coast is 0-1. Annie going for Kiwi Kid. That's his roam strategy. You can almost tell right now. Dignitas is going to be doing a lot of lane swapping. Kiwi Kid's going to be roaming on Annie.
Crumb's picking up that Evelynn. This is what he played last time that Coast and Dignitas matched up. Obviously coming out with the win, so he's going to try to wreak havoc on Nintendo. Somebody, as we said, a lot of people see as a bit of a weak link in the jungle to be found out quite easily. And it's not a weak link that it's not that he can't do anything. It's that once somebody does do something against him, it's hard for Nintendo to come back, especially with Coast being behind in lanes.
Yeah. It's kind of insult getting out of the injury sometimes since Shifter demands so much of the team's resources sometimes, as well as Zion not necessarily playing tanks. You factor in the fact that Nintendo gives many of his blue buffs to Shifter, and then that Zion is often super split push heavy guy himself. It just makes things hard for Nintendo.
Fist bump communication going on as the Pantheon. Yeah.
Nice lock in.
And the Dragon are locked in. High level lock ins. This is how
Pantheon.
It happens.
Pantheon jungle.
Feels good when you lock in an LCS champion.
Pretty heavy dive team they got going on.
Oh, man.
Yep. And then Dignitas as well.
I was going to say, which one are you talking
about?
Zed.
So that'll be the second Zed game for Golden Glue. As Crumb said, the record doesn't necessarily speak that well for Golden Glue. He said it didn't matter. It's just about him improving game over game. 2-1, Dignitas' schedule has actually been fairly easy since they picked him up. But if they win this one, pop them up to that. They're already 3-1, I believe. They would end up going 4-1 with him, which would be quite a streak. Is that going to be Zinzawi to carry?
Oh,
what's going on?
God, even the Ryze lock-in.
Ryze mid?
That's true. Yeah. We have the Shyvana. Mm-hmm. Yes.
That's actually.
It. They're still swapping this. This is going to be a first Ryze coming in for Shifter if it gets that lock-in.
It would make sense.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's all about how quickly he can start getting his armor itemization. Otherwise, he's going to be a piece of paper for Zed to rip through once he hits level 6. But the eventual build of Ryze with the Glacial Shroud and even the shield from Seraphs is really, really strong if he can get to that point. I like that choice against Zed. I really want to see how it plays out with Shifter versus Golden Glue.
You're laughing, or I saw laughing, and that might have been Golden Glue being quite loud.
Dignitas always laughs, even in defeat.
This is true.
They're just a happy bunch of guys.
Got to have good communication. I know what's going on. You see Dignitas, Coast facing off on the screen. And now we face you as a champion. Stride onto the Rift. Let's see who you voted for to win this one. According to LOL Esports, 74% of you think that Dignitas will come out on top of this game versus Coast. See what happens. Golden Glue's been getting a lot of fans back for behind Dignitas after
giving
his
them,
play.
Giving them a little bit of hope right here as they try and move into the playoffs on a winning streak. Likewise for Coast, they really have to figure things out, is I think the best way I can put it. They had that nice streak of games. I think they won 5 or 6 going into that Super Week. Not this Super Week, the one before that.
Yeah.
And they went 0-4 from there, and they just really haven't recovered.
Well, it's strenuous to go in a game knowing that it almost depends on the solo lanes. I mean, you can say that about any game, but even more so, if those don't go well, Coast just kind of, you know, dribbles away. They're not able to do much in the game, and it just keeps getting pushed on and pushed on. WizFusion will head to the bottom lane and farm as much as he can to try and get back, and it's just slow going from there as the opposing team takes the win. Coast trying to stay away from that pit in this one. Trying to make the leap for the victory as they start off on the map. Dig hovers the bottom side, and Coast is going to go right down the mid.
Level 1 potential. Kiwi Kid charging up his stun. He's going to be looking for some action early on in the game. So he's going to run himself pretty low on mana since they had to get out of the fountain immediately. So therefore,
Cutie Pie on the Corky pickup this time. There used to be a lot of Corky being played. Cop was a Corky player. Cutie Pie is a Corky player. It'd be good to see him back on a champion he enjoys playing. See where Golden Glue decides to go after he laughs his face off. Looks like he's just going to hang out towards Wraiths. Nothing big coming from him. They're not giving too much to the top side. They're saying, we're going for your blue because you're going for our blue. But they're not going for their blue.
No wards out early on in the game, so all of this is blind.
Yeah.
Support still not trending towards early wards. They are much rather content with the health crystal for better laning power or lane swapping goodness, which is generally the default a lot of these guys have went for.
No invade. Everybody backing off. One of the first games we're going to have this so far, but the late invade, still stands. We're just not there yet. Looking at the 140 to walk in, and Coast is going to try to get an upper hand. Possibly with when we see the 2v1, we don't have a Jinx in this game, and Coast may suffer greatly for that in the top lane if they decide to go through with this.
It really depends on the amount of people they choose to stack in that lane, though.
That's right.
You know, if they do a four-man push, if any of you guys caught the Challenger game yesterday, Challenger quarterfinals between Complexity Black and Complexity Red, there was a four-man stack in the top lane by Complexity Black, and they went all the way to the inhibitor turret. They actually took three within the first 4 minutes of the game.
It was quite wild. Definitely put the teams in a different pace that they had to organize. Took them a little bit to get back in as well. See what Dignitas and Coast can do to reassess the situation as it is going to be the 2v1. We see Cruiser pulling back into the jungle, and that means that we're going to have Zion Spartan roaming around with Nintendo for a bit.
By the way, last game when I mentioned how I feel like a lot of times the laner should just go to lane and help shoving. I got a lot of tweets telling me otherwise. I would have to say, there's pros and cons to all situations here. So basically, what happens now is the jungler gets the double buffs, and then they go to lane, and the double buffs and the superior level they'll have, because the jungle will be level 3 when they go to lane, allows for more threatening tower dives. But what ends up happening when there's 3 people in these lanes anyway is they're not even tower dive opportunities. People are respecting it too much, so they're not even approaching that situation. Therefore, I still think that eventually we will see a team send their top laner there and
right.
farm
there's
the jungle.
Chance. Yeah.
But they're just not doing that because it is a slightly risky maneuver.
Something you got to make sure it works in practice before you put it into play. All these teams going with what's been happening over the past few days and even weeks in their scrims. They're going to keep going through. Level 3 for Shifter here. Able to lock down some damage onto Golden Glue, and that looks like it's going to be a tough lane for him to start off 13-4 to get going there as we see the turrets start to drop on both lanes. Bottom one going down without that champion reduction on it. And the top one is still pretty darn healthy, and they only went with 3.
Coast real slow on this rotation. They spent a lot of time looking through the jungle, whereas Crumbs just went straight to it.
And Zion didn't get too much help. He even took the big Wraith sharing it along. He now gets level 2 as he just soaks up a bit of experience outside of damage range. But that's the first time he gets to.
Yeah. It definitely appears Dignitas is going to get a 2-for-1 if they want it, and if they went back to defend that turret. But for the meanwhile, a lot of it just has to do with that mid lane now, because they're isolated, because the junglers are completely in vision and there's no ganking potential. Shifter is punishing Golden Glue early on in the game. Starting with a mana crystal versus a health crystal start for Golden Glue, Shifter just shoved him right into the turret, so that's going to be very good for Shifter trying to get to tier or catalyst incredibly early on in the game. And even though Golden Glue has found a lot of success in team fights, quite honestly, his early game laning has been lackluster. He died at level 2 to high in their matchup against Cloud9, and has had some of the lowest CS at 10 minutes amongst mid laners in the LCS. Here, though, the gank finally coming in for Shifter.
He's playing quite strong. He thinks with this 2v1 swap, he's safe to push down in mid lane, but he is not safe at all. A very good call by Crumbs and Crew to come in and get the first attack in and first blood. They're not done with this one yet. That Daybreak going out into Crumbs, but they keep it safe. Level 4s to level 2 level 3s.
Yeah, and now the rotation from Dignitas is coming in right clean here. They shoved him back early enough, but it's just not enough because Coast is matching with a rotation of their own.
Looks like Dig is going to get themselves into position for a very early dragon. We saw Curse doing this, a lot of level 4s, but we still have some level 3s and 5s here.
Oh, Daydreamin'.
Oh, this is what they called it out for. They are going to be able to take out Daydreamin' now. Crumb's coming up with a help for 2 on that one. He takes him for himself with assist going to Golden.
Dignitas quite a bit ahead there, and Golden Glue's Being pushed back really benefited Dignitas in the long run there. Shifter overextended his welcome, and that really chained into two of those kills, because once Dignitas fell back, Coast was actually expecting an early dragon, because that's something Dignitas does a lot of. That's the whole reason Daydream is able to get caught as well, granting two assists for Golden Glue with that early walk sword.
Crumbs. He is just waiting for another party, knowing the flash is down onto Shifter, being relentless and already level 5 in the jungle. He's got a level on Nintendude who has not seen any presence. No real ganks coming in from him. We actually saw Crumbs walking over to him and Daydreaming in a 2v1 to start off that last fight.
Yeah, and Crumbs finished off his Spirit of the Elder Lizard at 6 minutes, which is quite impressive. The conservation passive on that is going to end up giving him a fair bit of gold before Nintendo can even complete it. The earlier you can get into gold-generating items, almost the more snowball-y they become, in a sense, because you had a lot of money in the first place to get the gold-generating item, but then you're generating more gold than the other person on top of that.
Without being hindered as well, Crumbs is probably going to be able to just waltz his way over. He's going through some wards first, so he'll be seen, but he's going to try to give some aggression over to Nintendude. If they have the timing right onto this one, you can see Nintendude hovering bottom side, as well as Coast, sending Daydreaming over there. That's only Wiz Fusion to farm in the top lane. They're just trying to repair what's happened.
And check this out. We're only 7 minutes into the game. There's already 3 sweepers on Dignitas. They're absolutely putting a huge emphasis on controlling vision because they know KiwiKid's going to be roaming around so much. And in order for KiwiKid to find those stuns, he needs to clear out the wards.
He did say he loves that 3-minute sight stone with the tower pushes that happen now. Supports get vision out a lot earlier with the trinkets being down. 722. Let's see what Cruiser can do to push out this wave. He has teleport still, has not used it yet, so it's kind of that ace in their pocket they can still use against Coast. Very low level still on both sides.
Yeah, this game has just been really rotation heavy. MaCutiePie has been pretty much on his lonesome this whole time.
AD carry is now to soak up farm in the bottom lane. They don't even want to push themselves into a scary situation. Dig had such a hold on what they were doing in those lanes, but now it doesn't seem like either team has enough sweepers or wards to get themselves into the jungle. You can see how much Coast is putting just on keeping their blue buff to themselves. Pink wards and 3 wards surrounding it. Now returning to the bottom lane, we're going to get the 2v2s to match up here, and KiwiKid has to be careful in this situation. He could pop, but Crumbs is there.
Trying for a counter. KiwiPie got poked down so low, he was hoping the Daydreaming went in.
Won't take the bait just yet. Too much of a minion wave. They know they can't just go in on this. Somebody else has to be there if Dig's playing that aggressive. Crumbs gets himself.
It.
Yeah, they know that sixth sense coming in. Yeah. And they set up a nice pink ward.
Crumbs, despite the 2 kills right here, really just trying to take advantage of that. While Nintendude desperately tries to get up to level 6. Crumbs way ahead of him right now. Just a question of what advantage they can take. They're clearing out the pink wards quite quickly, and a lot of expense paid by Coast to get all these pink wards out. But since they don't have the map control to maintain them, it only gives them temporary safety.
Man, if Nintendo could not go, and you think of what a Pantheon would do once everybody gathers in mid after the turrets get taken down. So many opportunities to be ganks coming in, but Dig has this much control. Nintendo Dax may be waiting for a lot of those man drops.
Dignitas actually doesn't know that Nintendo's only level 5 here, so they're worried about the Grand Skyfall as far as this dragon comes down. They're forcing it anyway, though, because they have all 5 people here. Flash!
Quite a bit of damage. Very nice hit. A huge Valkyrie in from KiwiPie. Whoa, to the front line. Zion Spartan comes in. He is going to be trying to do some big damage off of the teleport. Hits up KiwiPie for a kill. Not many people have the damage to take on Zion, and he is going to be getting another kill for himself. Twin Bite to come up onto KiwiKid. Should be enough. Actually, looks like he's trying to leave it up to one of his teammates. They're not going to make it in range in time, and he does get the final kill for himself. Picking up one there. Looks like Coast is going to push a little bit on the bottom lane and relieve pressure to get Dragon.
Yep, Dragon was a very dangerous objective there, and despite not having the Grand Skyfall, look how low Crumbs was before this fight started. And even though they got a clean initiation, they overdumped their damage onto Wiz Fusion. Notice how Cruiser and Golden Glue went onto Wiz Fusion, and then the Death Mark didn't even have to apply. That meant the rest of Coast could just run through the Dignitas team, take advantage of KiwiKid's low level with no stun because he had burned it for the initiate, and it ends up pulling Coast back in this game.
Zion Spartan keeping himself off in these lanes, getting as much farm as possible, and just with the Giant's Belt is enough to come in and make an impact on that fight. Coast getting a little bit of ground. It's exactly what they needed for momentum in this game. Still down in gold. due to all the kills that have been going over to Dignitas and the amount of control they have coming into the map with CS. But Coast doing very good at staving off the bleeding that started.
Yeah, at the moment, item thresholds are pretty even. The worry, if you're Dignitas right now, is Shifter's items. He's completed his catalyst in his tier and is not being denied farm, which is absolutely critical at this moment. Ryze will be able to scale up very well and block most of Dignitas' damage there, since it is a Zed physical damage and Lee Sin also physical damage in the solo lanes.
That was something I was thinking Coast may have had in mind, that the 2v1 swap would pull everything away so Shifter could have his own lane against Golden Glue, knowing he would have a bit of an edge with that
this
play.
This is a counter gank opportunity for Crumbs here.
Here's that level 6. They look for the Q over to I'm a Cutie Pie, but they can't really activate anything. Crumbs shows himself. Not going to be. Yes, actually, Cruiser did not stop that teleport. Get some flashes out of the team. Daydreaming will go down in this one in the end valiantly, as the rest make it out alive, but Dig is trying to grab back those moves.
Yeah, they had the teleport up from the previous fight, so they took advantage of that right there. Bit of a telegraph gank there by Pantheon with the early movement from Coast meant the teleport could be crafted down there by Dig. Get the kill and push Coast back.
Shifter still trying to build himself up in mid. Golden Glue's brought himself up in CS with all the chaos that's been happening. He's gotten back to the jungle. He's been farming Wraith as much as possible, keeping himself against Shifter in a position to carry the game. That's a level 9-9, so he's doing just right with the team now off on the wing. Shifter's flash is up, but is it going to be enough? They close the gap way too fast, and Dignitas picks up another one.
Exactly what Dignitas has to do. They have to attack Shifter before he gets huge, and he is pushing up the lane in order to try to get his farm. So another roam by KiwiKid really started that, landing the stun post-flash of Shifter and securing the kill for Dignitas.
22 minutes and Shifter will have that newly purchased Rod of Ages fully charged.
Got that pretty fast despite all that's been happening.
Still stacking up on that tier.
Bypassing the boots. Playing a very dangerous style of Ryze, cost him 2 deaths.
Just under 260 on the stack, so we can tell he's been getting a lot of trouble in that mid lane. Cruiser returning to top after wasting. Oh, wasting. It came up nicely on that gank in the bottom lane, but after using his teleport, Coast tries to regain a bit of the map here so they can at least put some posture back into play. We saw Curse getting just bushwhacks last game on CLG that helped. They could be going back for that.
Pretty critical ward kills there.
Yeah.
You don't think it, but when two pink wards get killed, that's 200 gold. It's like one, I want to say, almost half of a kill in gold. Normal kill being 450 gold. Obviously the kill being 300, and then 50% of that is the assist pool, which is divided evenly amongst the people who get assists. I didn't know that for the longest time.
Because math.
Yeah. Well, it also changed in the most recent season.
Right. So. And then the whole assist thing. And it's fun.
A lot of craziness.
A lot of numbers. Got 2,000 gold for Dignitas right now that they're not really trying to push too much. They have gotten those few kills, but they don't want to overextend themselves. It all looks good for now, and they're keeping it that way. Two turrets to one. The bottom lane's not getting much focus, as we're going to see probably a top push to the mid push, trying to open up the map, maybe start focusing on some of the blues. Shifter's going to have a lot of mana, but blue buff is still nice.
Yeah, the blue buff allows him to spam much more, and it's actually critical for getting out damage rotations on Ryze mid team fight. While he gets cooldown reduction from his Q, with the blue buff, it puts him to 25% cooldown reduction. You want to get to 40 on Ryze as quickly as possible because it really allows you to machine gun your spells, whereas he can't really do that at this juncture.
Pings into the bottom lane. Looks like Daydream and a Wiz Fusion are waiting off in the wing for an initiation here, but it would be quite big. Tibbers is up for KiwiKid. Knowing KiwiKid, he has that stun ready. Crumbs looking for another one in mid, throws down the Agony's Embrace. Isn't enough though, gotta watch out for the Rune Prison right under the turret. Here comes that damage output from Shifter. It's gonna be a little late from Nintendude. They didn't think they were gonna go all the way under the turret.
Yeah, that was just a sliver away from being effective because Golden Glue could never get in range for the death mark.
Playing security here, Golden Glue, knowing that Crumbs was in danger, gets him to safety. Cutie Pie is kind of rotating around the backside here. He's going
to
be in mid, but I don't
Coast
think
really
they'll be
wants
quick
to dive
enough.
This one. Therefore, Dignitas pulls far away.
Yeah. He's going to have Cruiser in the top lane doing what he can against that turret. I see him throwing out spells, putting on Iron Will, trying to give himself those two hits of attack speed. He should be able to get this down, but he may actually meet Zion Spartan here for a bit before he gets it. Should be a pretty good matchup.
Yeah, it's always interesting watching Lee Sin get turrets because every time he uses a spell. Oh, there's a dive.
Coming in very big. Golden Glue gets himself in a sticky situation. He's going to go down. Nintendo gets out with a sliver of health on that one. Wiz Fusion looks to pressure a little bit more with the culling. Can't find a kill.
Yeah, that was a poorly executed dive there by Dignitas, splitting focus between kills and turrets. And the timing could not be worse as this dragon is about to be taken by Coast.
5 seconds. Pieces are already in place, and the pink wards are on the other side for Dignitas. They're really only ready to approach the dragon pit, not be inside of it. And it looks like it doesn't mean the time for Coast to get it either. Wiz Fusion on the bottom half, Crumbs not with red buff on this one, so it's definitely going to be the chase, but he's going to walk right into him. He gets the first hate spike. Now Wiz Fusion realizes there's a fight going on. He was not aware of that right in the first spot, and it looks like Coast will have enough positioning to still grab dragon. A little scary there.
Nice play by Crumbs to scare him off a little bit, but the team had just forfeited so many advantages with that failed turret dive. The Coast was still able to get that one. So good heady play by them right there. Shifter getting the one kill and then also surviving a little bit longer with that blue buff is going to make him a scary threat. His next item is when he starts getting that armor itemization. That is going to be really huge for him.
See how much gold he's sitting on right now. Just about 2,000. Shifter knows he can keep himself safe in lane. He's been ganked quite a few times, and he knows something's coming as well. Runs off that one with the ward coverage. Keeping himself safe, so those buys might be coming a little bit sooner than we thought.
Yeah, he can pick up his Glacial Shroud right now. But he goes Sorcerer's Shoes, so he's going for the move speed. And, of course, just a little bit of armor.
Yeah.
This is Zed-proofing.
He skips the mana, something he's already charging very heavily right now. So gets himself into a good position, using that money efficiently. And, oh dear. Nope. You're good. Pink ward on pink ward. Who's going to fight it, though? This is going to be a battle and a half. Oh, he wishes he could throw his sword. 2K gold, and it's going to go up a little bit here, Kiwi Kid. They get a good force out just to get the coverage onto Baron. So many Baron attempts have been coming out in this super week with the amount of jump it gives the teams and where they've been sitting in the games after these 2v1s. That bit of stat and gold that it provides has been even more than it usually. See where they go with this. Good mid lane push, but doesn't look like they can even get to the turret. They're clear of the Zenith Blade into the Spell Flux and everything Machine Gun Rise does as he puts a new magazine in.
Yeah, at this point, Dignitas is roaming to try and find their opportunity. They're a little bit gun-shy right now after Golden Glue died in the mid lane and Coast was able to take the dragon afterwards. At this point, they're just kind of split pushing around. I also noticed the Sorcerer Shoes on I'm a Cutie Pie's Corki. It's something we ended up seeing a lot at Worlds last year when Corki was big, because he does actually more magic damage to champions over the course of a game than physical damage in most situations. His Phosphorus Bomb is magic damage, and his ultimate is magic damage. Plus, he gets true damage shred on his passive. So it's actually really difficult for Corki to itemize penetration properly. But the Sorcerer Shoes are a step to making the Rockets and the Poke gameplay of Corki more powerful while sacrificing a bit of the physical damage side.
Now, how do they actually start using their composition now that it's getting late game? They have to start considering any engagements. You have the poke of that Corki, but really that's only from him.
I really think it has a lot to do with Crumbs flanking properly. Most of these Eve compositions need the Eve to get the ultimate down first, since it is the percentage current health, and coming in later doesn't really help them. Meanwhile, I also think it's heavily dependent on Cruiser's ability to split push and then force either 5v3s or 4v5s for Dignitas' favor. So a lot of it just has to do with those top two guys on Dig, Cruiser and Crumbs.
Golden Glue taking it upon himself towards the bottom lane since he has the safety of Zed to get that split push on, and Cruiser's going to join with the team. The teleport, definitely a little different, but they're going to try to keep the damage on the turret and the pressure as well, which Zed may have provided more of, but they're doing what they got to do to get themselves ahead. And we see it's actually Golden Glue trying to come around from the side. Mm. Hopefully he doesn't get himself in a bad spot again.
Also, when we were talking to Kiwi in the interview earlier,
he
was mentioning how he picks Annie so much because Dignitas has trouble closing without a hard initiation from a support. So a Flash Tibbers could very well be a start of a fight for Dignitas, but Nintendo starts it for himself.
Flash is about to come up for Kiwi Kid, so they may have found Coast in that choke point we've heard so many players talk about during the disengage. No team bites after the man drop. Golden Glue's going to force someone to come down. That Shifter, you can see him just on the top of the screen. They're going to duke it out. back and forth until this mid turret goes down.
Dignitas actually has two solo laners capable of split pushing right now. Zed and Lee Sin are both very potent, but the reason Lee Sin is with the team is because he can disengage for the team better than Golden Glue could with Lee Sin kick.
Making sure everything is safe. Hard hats on for Dig. They get down a turret for themselves and make sure they get a lot of wards swept out. We've been seeing them use those three sweepers for the past 10 minutes now. Very early sight stones coming from these 2v1s. And it's just Coast trying to regroup and get their three sight stones in.
Yeah.
Golden Glue to safety. Shifter to clean up the bottom lane. We got a minute 30 on to Dragon. This could actually be a very big fight coming in for Coast now that Nintendo does have his man drop up for one of these Dragon fights.
He's yet to find a good initiation with the Pantheon ultimate, but it's tough to lock down the Dignitas team. Highly mobile. Corkazet and Lee Sin all able to disengage fairly well. Eva's invisible, so it's hard to find her.
The longer this game goes, too, Golden Glue doesn't have too many targets. He's going to be able to death mark out. Everybody's getting at least tanky enough to survive an initial burst. But like you said, with Kiwi Kid flashing into your face with that Tibbers, it's going to be hard to get anywhere. Both teams kind of want to gap close on. These late fights should be pretty brutal.
Another one of these games where there's heavy amounts of turrets killed early.
Yeah.
So the mid-game fights actually end up being quite explosive. Teams have relatively close gold totals when they meet, but more gold than you're used to seeing. So
yeah.
Obviously, Glacial Shroud being completed on a shifter gives him a lot of cooldown reduction. If he wants, it would be really great for him if he could get a blue buff before that as well, but his blue is not spawned yet. Since Dignitas has the gold lead, you'd expect them to have an initiation plan here. A lot of it's going to have to do with pink ward control around the Dragon Pit and whether Crumbs can get in a clean ultimate or not, as well as if Nintendo is trapped within the Dragon Pit, or if he ults out, or if he gets caught out there. That was close.
Wow, Nintendo not in the right spot. There, Daydreamer gets a nice solar flare down, and they take down Kiwi Kid. The initiation was used, but now everything after is in defense for Dignitas. Great shots coming from Wiz. They're not able to finish off Golden Glue. A lot of Coast is that front-end damage. If they don't have the follow-up in the fight, they're not going to get the kills. You can see it's always that 20, 50%. There, can they follow up on it? No! Once again, just getting out with a sliver of health. Coast, get in position on that, though, and they may grab the dragon.
Yeah, even if Nintendo Dex was initiated upon, it was just the single person that get hit by the Tibbers, and the rest of Coast could pile on. The sustained damage of Ryze and Javanna is greater than what Dignitas can offer with their composition. It's actually not even the smite that gets it, but a powerful shifter.
It's that front-end burst. Nintendo wasn't even thinking it was going to be that much, but we saw in this fight one time after another.
Well, check this out. When they initiated, Cruiser and Zed were not in position, so it was actually a 3v5 start to that fight. And Coast collapsed better than the rest of Dignitas did. Crumbs could not flank with the ultimate, and then Golden Glue was immediately shut down with his death mark. The pop doesn't really do much to his fusion there, which meant the rest of Coast could chase down with their sustained damage. We eventually saw Flash Rune Prison that got another kill for them. And Coast claws their way even farther back in this game.
Yeah, 1.4 thousand gold in the lead for Dignitas now. And that lead keeps shrinking. Coast doing everything right this game, and everybody coming up pretty nicely in the fights, too. It's not just one person solely carrying the team. All the kills are across the board.
And even though Coast hasn't turned the corner yet,
right,
them being on a pretty bad winning streak here for Super Week, judging by their earlier game against TSM, they're getting there. You know, this style of game where there's heavy lane swapping and an isolated mid lane really favors them. Daydreaming gets kicked.
Uses the cripple to get a few extra steps by him to kick him back at Crumbs. Very well organized by the team to close in on that kill.
Yeah, nice force there. Trying to not get 5-on-5 team fights against Shifter's Ryze, which is very powerful right now.
Now trying to get a throw on.
Jumping on Crumbs.
Oh, this is the man drop that Nintendo's been looking for. Grand Skyfall coming down right onto Crumbs. He uses the W and gets out quick. He knew he could be the one to take brute force if it happened. Dignitas plays that one as well as they can with Cutie Pie pushing the mid lane, trying to do what he can to play off the ball on this.
Tibbers burned there by Kiwi Kid, but no kills granted by Coast. Coast burned a fair bit for that. The turret and map pressure is still in the favor of Dignitas, but they haven't been able to close out any big team fights. And that could continue. I really feel like for Dignitas to win this game, they have to catch initiations where Coast is unawares or not there with five people.
Yeah.
But if Coast can continually stay grouped and ward off the split push, they will eventually outscale Dignitas.
making sure they definitely have enough HP. And the Saris Embrace.
That being completed.
25 just completed in maybe a little bit ago. But Nintendo, Zion, as well as Daydreamin' getting those Giants belt. Surviving a little bit from Kiwi's burst after watching what happened in that last fight to Nintendo off the bat. His Hex Drinker as well, keeping him healthy. And Coast now trying to reposition, put themselves in a spot here to find the middle lane of Dignitas on the second tier. Once they can open that up, it's really just around the horn, and they can back up for Dragon whenever they want, as long as they have the wards.
Absolutely. Cruiser going in for an initiation.
Whoa!
Kicks back Daydream.
Nobody's really there to follow up. He's like, hey, I can get this, but nobody else can gap close with me. Still knows he has a bit of life to bait with. Nintendo could go down. He actually takes him, but he takes the Q at the same time as they draw for the kill. Another one going on to Shifter. Great coordination from Coast. Dig trying to put themselves back in the right spot, but Golden Glue too hurt early in the fight. Now it's Kiwi Kid who cannot throw out more of that front end damage to continue the DPS. That was a sweeper just on the other side. Golden Glue, I believe that was his to make sure he wasn't being seen, but Coast still sniffing him out, trying to pursue. There's going to be the flame. Doesn't get it. He's trying to walk his way out there through. The Randuin's goes down. It's only a matter of time before the Dragon gets its food.
An ace from Coast showing their team fight superiority. That was another situation where Dignitas tried to get the catch, but it wasn't quite enough. Watch just the positioning of people right here. Cutie Pie and the other AD carry are not in this fight quite yet, and the follow-up on the kick, it's hard to kill a Leona, and it's not necessarily that beneficial when she still lands a great stun. Then when the fight really does break out, Shifter is in the middle, but not immediately focused down. He got a lot of damage off. Then when the AD carries do arrive, Cutie Pie had a tank in his face, so Coast could still pile on through the end of this one. Just a little bit slow on the follow-up for Dignitas would be the story of that fight. And it really benefits Coast in the long run.
Very well played. Dig realizing just how big Shifter has gotten throughout this game. It took him the better half of the early part of that fight.
Yeah. But really,
to take him down.
He's not necessarily the biggest one after the results of that fight. It's Zion's Shyvana. As well as Wiz Fusion now, who has reached carry potential with those three items. These are really the moments for Coast to turn the corner. When someone other than Zion Spartan or Shifter gets a triple kill or more in a team fight, you know, what are they going to be able to do with this gold? Is Wiz Fusion now going to be able to become the focal point of Dignitas' focus and survive through it? That'll be the test.
Just in the beginning of the game. Oh.
Another
little miscommunication there.
He's pretty tanky.
Wow, Kiwi Kid gets hit up as well. The solar flare was in front of the screen, and he got knocked right in the nose with it. Kiwi Kid goes down 30 seconds on the death chamber. 40 coming in for Dragon, and Coast is making moves to put pressure in the top lane.
He is actually very close to a Randwin's Omen right now. Just needs 700 more gold on Leona. They need to find a new target of focus to get catches right now. Daydreamin is out there getting ward control, and every time they try and initiate onto Daydreamin, it is backfired. We got to do something new.
They are just diving past the turret for Coast. It looks like Dignitas is going to have to back off on that one. Inhibitor turret will fall. Coast, like I said, if they have the wards, can easily disengage on this and go back for Dragon, but Dig's not going to let him get too far. Trying to zero them out immediately. Getting himself into a bad spot, using as many of the shadows as he can. And it looks like Golden Clue gets himself out alive of the fight. They're now trying to chase down Coast. Cruiser gets hit up. A nice lockdown coming in from Nintendo and the rest of the team. Chaotic battles. Going in for the one for Coast.
Yeah, when Kiwi Kid isn't there for the drop tibbers, there's not the most hard initiation for Dignitas, and Coast is able to disengage fairly well. The reason they dove that turret so confidently is I'm a Cutie Pie was in the mid lane. So it was completely one-sided as far as people in that fight.
I was saying before, Cutie Pie, they're looking actually Kiwi Kid. Just on the outside, any stragglers trying to back that they can get an advantage on, they are going to grab, but they find nothing. And seeing this play style, we hear TSM mainly say 4.4 kind of put a crutch on us in the way we play.
Dignitas said that, especially the 4.5 patch, they can't wait for it to change more.
Oh dear, coming in nice. Crumbs gets the lockdown on the smite, but how much is that going to count? They go ahead, get a quick kill on the Golden Glue, and get themselves.
I wonder if that's going to force a Baron try. They know that Crumbs is very low and that they have just killed Golden Glue. They're going to go for this one. They have a little bit of ward control, not the best ward sweeping, but they might just try and fast rush down this Baron.
Sweet ward behind. Daydreamin' making sure he's getting that sweeper out with the upgraded Oracle Sweeper, Oracle's Lens. And now it's going to be on his Solar Flare. Solar Flare down to start this fight. Nintendude goes in for himself. Still looking for Tibbers from Kiwi Kid. And he looks like he's going to be on the backside, not really able to get anything out for himself with the help of Tibbers.
That was initiated by Tibbers, and Crumbs could not get in range for a nice ultimate from Eve. He did not want to go in there, still trying to hold him off. Coast is a little bit lower, and there's one fewer member on Dingitas. Nice catch!
16, but Daydream is level 12, and he gets instantly blown up as they try to go into Cutie Pie. Zion Spartan's been quite big. Shifter's still in the fight, but big damage actually coming out in the area of effect sense. And Coast takes a good hit there as Cutie Pie turns around. Bit of that auto attack damage, red buff on, so Crumbs can also collectively get some damage on. The few more shots, the Saracen Brave Shield could save him, but he goes down, a big one coming out from Cutie Pie to finalize it.
So all told, they traded 3 kills for 2, I believe, or maybe it was 3 kills for 2, and they did stop the Baron, which is the most critical thing about that. Wizfusion still at 7 kills, but Dignitas comes out of that one actually in the advantage.
Crazy how the AD carries are staying somewhat even here. Cutie Pie still in the chase at like 75 farm ahead with kills and assists under his belt. But Wizfusion, as I was saying before, this patch of rotating a lot and not him just farming in a lane, getting kills with the team is really helping the team altogether. Instead, like I said before, of just having one lane carry. A lot more teamwork coming out of Coast here. 15 to 11, they finally grab the gold lead back, Jat, and have 6-5 in turrets.
Yeah, this game is really anyone's match as of now. Coast showing some teamfight superiority, and so...
Alrighty.
Yeah, he jumped.
Looks like he could have been close to Kiwi, but he sees the circle a little too early. Enough walls to play with there so we can play Ring Around the Rosie, and just ward coverage for Coast to come up here. Still 3 sweepers only on each side. Nobody's gone for the 4th one yet, but the highest upgraded, like I said, Oracle Lens is out for Kiwi and Daydreamin'. Yeah! The Randuin's ward.
He didn't want to do that. They're actually down a few critical spells right here. No Grand Skyfall, no Randuin's, which is pretty important for Daydreamin'. Dignitas doesn't know that the Randuin's, or maybe they did, I think the ward saw him pop the Randuin's.
It probably, it would have. It's right behind the red buff. They are privy to the information of the active use. Seraph's Embrace is coming back up. A lot of things are close to coming back up. Ignite as well for Shifter. They may be just trying to bide a little bit of time here as they walk in a group down mid lane. Finally pressure back onto a turret. We've been hovering out in the map for quite some time here. Looks like Coast wants to make a move. Or not.
Yeah, they're really just going to try and play cat and mouse around this Baron pit. Mm-hmm. They've done a great job clawing their way back. Shifter now with the Banshee's Veil as well. I keep bringing him up even though he's 2-4 and 8 because you can tell Dignitas really prioritizes killing him. Ryze has ridiculous sustained damage in team fights.
Leave him alone for a second, and that's the wrong decision. You see double buffs of blue on both Golden Goo, Glue, and I'm a Cutie Pie, so they're rocking double blues on Dig. See if they can start spitting out a little bit of damage. They don't really want to get close. Daydreamin has been locking down Solar Flares, and really Coast's initiation, once they take out Kiwi Kid, they can kind of roam free in that fight.
This blue buff on I'm a Cutie Pie, though, is actually spectacular. His missile poke has been keeping Coast back. And Dignitas, in these close games, has really been using Baron as a way of deciding them, for better or for worse. It's been better for them lately, and this is an aggressive force, knowing they force some Coast people back.
Yeah, the Baron is now a problem. Dignitas tries to give the other team the initiation on the Nintendude. Deja vu for Kiwi Kid, keeping the jungler out with Tibbers, and it looks like they try to get a big fight. Cruiser goes down instantly. Wizfusion's got some focus down. Cutie Pie takes one as he makes his way out of the fight. That's Nintendude going down. And it looks like Kiwi Kid will be able to get the safety here.
Everybody scatter. We got the Baron. Now get out of there. That's what Dignitas is basically doing. They were all in the pit against that AoE damage, and Coast would have wrecked them. Are they really going to get away from this one? Kiwi Kid, he's got a long way to run and no turret to defend himself.
No flash, no ignite. Hit after. Oh, there's the passive movement speed coming in from Wiz. Gets the Ardent Blaze, gets the last few shots. They get what they work for.
Even so, Dignitas got the Baron.
They did.
2 kills for 1. It's actually worth it for them. And Cutie Pie was going in for some more after that. Nothing much is going to happen there. This was really just all about the smite secure. Nintendude was stunned and initiated on, which is what stopped that. And actually, big time kill coming in from out of Cutie Pie. Ooh, Crumbs is trying to come around from the back. No ultimate to slow, though. We'll find a dragon.
Oh, I don't think Zion Spartan knew he was going to find that there. Ward in the brush,
well, that's
actually going very hard in. Could he be getting there? Shifter hits it up quite hard. Nintendude gets himself into the fight with Mandrop, but it looks like he is turning tail as soon as he falls. Zion Spartan just says, don't bring him to me! Oh, man. 30 seconds on the clock, and Coast is not going to be in position to be grabbing the dragon. If it's even what Dignitas wants, they're going to have an open map to run through. But back fight. Oh! There you go. Had to sidestep
real quick.
That
was a big smile on Amakuni Spy's face. He could have finished him off a little bit earlier, but he wanted to play with his food a little bit.
I feel like I've seen that before in solo queue or something.
Yeah.
The kills are getting quite equaled out here. Dignitas picking up 3,000 gold. The Baron, a very big move for them. Like you said, using Baron now, which was a crutch for them to decide games for them.
Yeah, and this has been much for the better. And it was actually Coast pushing down the bottom lane after the Baron had been taken, trying to get an advantage off the two kills that got them into the situation in the first place. And really, a spectacular teleport by Cruiser that ended up really catching them for that fight. Gives Dignitas this big advantage. I wonder how much they're going to try and press here, as they still are sitting with that Baron buff. Dragon is up, though. They might just go take that. That's a smart move.
Looks like they'll put themselves a nice chunk of gold up. That Dragon is now at its highest average level of the game. It's going to be spitting out a good amount of gold. And with that gold, Dignitas will continue to move across the map. It's quite stronger right now than we are seeing on Coast. Initiations like this, especially because they have a Talisman of Ascension up and can continue these fights.
Yeah.
Coast is not.
It's turning into a bit of a battle of the 80 carries right now, actually.
I like it.
Yeah, I'm a cutie pie.
He brought himself up this game. He was at like 3, 2, and 4, but he had more CS. And now he's everything.
Yeah, just finished his Infinity Edge, whereas Wiz Fusion has as well.
Mm-hmm.
Cutie Pie has more gold overall in items because he has a Negatron Cloak as well. You can see 15.8k to 14.7k.
Not a grand.
However, as we mentioned earlier, Corki has a very big mix between magic and physical damage. So you can see he's trying to make up for that by going with Sorcerer's Shoes and a Last Whisper, but it's just not as efficient as far as the way his damage comes out. And Wiz Fusion will be more efficient with his armor penetration. Mm. With his physical damage. As such, I believe Lucian scales better with the equal amount of gold than Corki does. So I'm a cutie pie really has to either maintain the small lead he has or just play better in order to out carry Wiz Fusion.
See how good Wiz Fusion can relentless pursuit and dash around the missiles. If we do get the 1v1, it'd be quite awesome to see. Right now, with nearly 100 CS between the 80 carries, it's interesting to think that both of them could really go toe to toe at this point. Looking at quite a gold lead now, 6,000. Actually ticked up 5,000 gold in favor of Dignitas. Is there slow going this one? They don't want to put themselves in a bad spot. The mid is seen by minions. They're not going to walk in the jungle and get any scary positions.
Yeah, this will be tricky. Watch for the flash initiate. The distortion boots have been completed. You're going to want to catch a couple people. And Kiwi Kid goes in. There it is.
Whoa, Kiwi Kid getting very close into the fight. The health bars are Golden Glue, and Kiwi going down very fast. Golden Glue is able to get himself back out to that initial shadow once again. Very good at that. And they are microing in and out, but Shifter's able to find one onto Cruiser. The back and forth leaves it at a 3-for-1 so far. And Coast is using the walls of their base to bolster up. Get some kills.
Very tough turret dive if they can't close out the sustained damage for Coast. That is a big step backwards for Dignitas. Cutie Pie is the only one to get out alive. And will he even get out alive?
I don't know. Chase. Ooh! Man drop going down once again. Nice Valkyrie by Cutie to keep himself safe, but it looks like the pursuit. No, it will stop. They're going to start pushing these lanes.
Yeah. Let's take another look at that fight.
That fight happened.
Yeah, the flash initiation wasn't necessarily immediately comboed. Watch how delayed Krupp's ultimate was as well. And then Cruiser kicked Shifter back. But remember, the 80 carry as well is Wiz Fusion. He's the one who's going to be finishing off a lot of these kills. Shifter just used his move speed to get back as well. And because I'm a Cutie Pie had to Valk out, he wasn't in there taking turret shots with the rest of his team, or at least taking advantage of Dignitas tanking turret shots. And the sustained damage advantage of Coast is superior. You know, Dignitas is mainly a split-pushing team at their core with this composition, Cruiser and Golden Glue. But that was a straight-up 5v5 that they tried to overforce, and they got punished for it.
It doesn't look like they can do too much unless they get the perfect fight this time. That was with the Guardian Angel. That was with everything they really needed to get in on that fight. Even Golden Glue threw out a shadow, and Kiwi Kid flashed onto the shadow, kind of tried to hide under it. Didn't work too well. Coast took him out right away as he tried to throw down Tibbers.
Hide in Golden Glue shadow.
Just kind of hide there. Almost worked. Looked pretty particle spammy. We'll see what they can do now. 40 minutes on the clock. Coast and Dig going at each other's throats right now as we're over 120,000 gold combined into this game. 7-6 in turrets. Both teams seeing what they can do to each other as Dignitas has it up to the inhibitor turrets. We've seen Coast there a little bit ago, but it's been very back and forth now in the game's in Dig's hands.
Miss Fusion completing his Banshee's Veil as well. It's going to help block Kiwi Kid's flash initiation stunts. There's no Mikhail's, though, on Daydreamin', so they can somehow land the stun on the Wiz Fusion. They have the potential to burst him down.
Mom, Melmordius on a Nintendo. Take consideration that damage from Corki and Crumbs.
Zion almost wants to be initiated on.
Everybody piling into the brush, huddling close to close.
Full tank Siobhan and no Blade of the Ruined King.
Nope.
Yet to die. Not too much sustained damage from Dignitas, which is why this full tank build on Zion is great. Again, the Baron Force.
Wow.
They trust their smite. They want this fight.
It's down to half. That's a very scary position. Three members on the timbers. Coast Shifter getting hit up quite hard. Wiz Fusion's way too close to the middle of the fight, but he gets in a perfect spot. A very nice culling. Coast is now on the retreat, however, and they can't help him to turn around. There is no peel for the team. Crumbs gets himself in a scary spot. Diggs already turned around for Baron.
It looked like a mess, but the execution from Dignitas was awesome there. Everyone got caught in a ball. All of Cutie Pie's damage hit, all of Crumbs' damage hit. They forced them out, and they get the Baron again.
Dignitas coming up big. Dictating fights with Baron now instead of having it cause them
Coast
the game.
Coast thought it was going to be a Baron steal again, which is why they grouped up, and it's exactly what Dignitas wanted. That time, Crumbs was in range for a perfect Eve ultimate, and everyone else could just pile on as well. Cruiser's kick actually hit everyone pretty much on the Coast team there, which is a surprising amount of damage. It's one of the big reasons they could wreck through there. Coast funneled in, Dignitas punished them.
Perfect positioning for the AoE fight. Diggs very happy with this one. Zanya's now onto Kiwi Kid. His flashes in are going to be a lot safer for himself. I don't know about the situation getting out, but he knows whatever flash in may be the last one they have to win this game.
Yeah, the Zanya's is going to be nice for Kiwi.
Yeah.
Real nice.
Do what you can, like Zanya's and Mikhail yourself and just run away.
Yeah, Mikhail yourself's out of the Zanya's. Just be like, wee!
Just kidding. Where is Dignitas going? Golden Blue with the help of Kiwi Kid. Looks like they're going to hover towards the top side as Dig just needs to keep up the pressure right now. Really nothing more to do than make sure Coast doesn't get anywhere that they don't know about.
Yeah, that's a really fascinating game now because Coast has proven that they are a superior 5v5 team unless Dignitas gets a picture-perfect initiation like we did before that Baron. But since Dignitas has been able to control those Baron buffs, they're now sitting with a map advantage and a decent gold lead. However, because we're so far into the game, 74,000 gold on a Dignitas, 67,000 gold on a Coast, max item builds are pretty much getting there. So I feel like Dignitas has this window where they are at least even in straight up 5v5, like perfectly played fights on both sides that they should try to take advantage of right now. But if they can't and we get another 10 minutes in or so, or Dignitas has another dive where they get about 4 deaths, Coast will then pull ahead because everyone will hit max items, and it would really be on Dignitas to try to find that advantageous fight. So, I mean, right now, like win percentage-wise, I'd say Dignitas is probably at like 65 to 70%, but the longer it goes, the closer it gets in Coast's favor.
Coast very good at figuring out what happens in the game and kind of organizing themselves around it if they have time. The inhibitor open now, and we'll see if this is something they can adapt to as Dignitas postures to take the top turret. They only have that one ward going down and a few sight stones in the inventories. They're just trying to keep vision of the fight. They are going to try and take possibly Wiz Fusion first, but we've seen how hard it is to get that back line. Kiwi Kid's flash and Tibbers is up. Everything they need right now is up on the side of Dignitas. Wiz Fusion's without a flash or a barrier. This is going to be tough.
You can see these games are longer than average for both of these teams, and Dignitas does not want to overcommit. Corki is not that great of an inhibitor sieger, but at the same time, if Coast loses this fight, they lose the game. It might actually be smart for them to give up this inhibitor. They're hoping that Dignitas overcommits for it, then they can get a clean initiation, but a lost fight here would be a lost game for Coast, whereas an inhibitor means they still have a chance to stall.
Imagine if Nintendo could just get back, jump behind them at the stairs right now, and then the team could squish them in. But with Nintendo in their vision, they know the jump's not coming from anywhere. They're almost safe.
Coast either fights them on this next initiation, or Dig gets the inhibitor and goes back out, because it's a couple hits away.
There it is. It may be a little too close. He pulls it.
He got it.
He actually is not going to go for the jump. The
inhibitor's dead.
Yeah, the inhibitor's dead.
It's a little
called
off
the jump.
It's dead. Yeah, he called off the jump. That would have been the worst of both situations, giving up the inhibitor and endangering themselves in that type of fight. there's only a small amount of time left on this Dignitas Baron buff. About 15 seconds, if my calculations are correct.
That's about right.
Yeah.
It's a quarter, 4 minutes on it, so you're good to go. See where they can use it. They have that 15 seconds
probably
to get on this.
Next wave.
As it wears off, watch to see if Coast does think of that advantage to go in. Whereas for the Solar Flare coming out of Daydream, and Dignitas loses it, and they're not as close as they were before. They know it's a little bit more dangerous. Turrets still do hurt, even this late in the game. Good damage and harass coming out of Golden and Glue, just applying that Black Cleaver over and over for Cutie Pie to get in if he wants, but he's going for the turret right now.
Yeah.
Methodical push.
Nintendo would have to go quite far behind if he wanted to get a real initiation down. But that would probably be a little bit too deep because they'd have to walk through the Tibber stun. And that's what Kiwi Kid has been very reliable at landing, if anything, in these fights. Dignitas wanting the hard initiation to end the game, but a lot of their advantages that they've taken have been if I'm a Cutie Pie pokes down adequately with his rockets. At the very least, to get rid of all those Banshees whips.
Definitely a lot preventing them. Oh, could this be the one that they want? Nobody's going to be close enough. That's quite a bit of time to wait. Pantheon's ult is not a short cooldown.
Yeah. But at this point, it's not the most reliable of initiations. And Coast has to peel back for this Nexus turn anyway. Shifter popping his ultimate for that. And the initiation on Intendude!
Intendude gets kicked away. He may not go down there. The Ignite is on him, and he will live with about 1 HP. The Culling comes out. Crumbs is trying to put himself in the front. He knows the Guardian Angel can take the hit. There's the Hexdrinker coming up. They have taken that off, and Crumbs is going to be pierced on now, taken down. Daydream is forced to flash out at the initiation! The big double kill coming out of the big rocket. Cutie Pie tries to stand toe-to-toe. Member Wiz's flash and his barrier are down. No, they've just come back up for this fight, and it keeps them alive!
Well, we asked earlier, it's going to be carry versus carry, fusion versus Cutie Pie, and they're kind of both doing it right now. The double kill from the big one from Amon Cutie Pie to close that out, and the survival by Wiz Fusion. Although, while all that was happening, Nexus turrets fall, and the pressure from Dignitas mounts.
God, I'm sure Cutie Pie and Wiz Fusion are feeling good. A lot of times the AD carries will say, we don't do much in the game anymore. These guys are the ones that are making the kills.
Well, remember, Ryze was off trying to defend that Nexus turret that just fell at the start of this fight. And then the initiation was a little bit scattered here from Coast. It is a big push and pull, and the long-range damage that Cutie Pie can provide is massive right here. Watch how low they are, and I believe he had the big one charged for that big rocket, max range pretty much. But then obviously, the nice baiting right here. Shifter is the one who really surprised everyone coming in there with a huge amount of damage, and Fusion is the beneficiary picking up those last few hits.
Great plays all around. We're getting pretty high up there in farm as well. 445 coming in for Cutie Pie right now. Everybody in the game. Oh, I'm a liar. Nintendo dude, 17.
Skara. Kiwi Kid said he is a great coach, but it is a very stressful situation not being able to impact the game. He can talk to them so much outside of the game. But once they're in there, it's all, why would they do something like that? Scar's down here. I'll throw him a poor old stress ball from the caster desk.
He's like, this is what it looks like from the outside. Oh my gosh. 49 minutes on the clock.
Big force here. Coast can't wait here long, because super minions will eventually push their base. So they either have to go for Baron right away or force an initiation right away.
The intensity is building. Final fights are what are going to come of these engagements. Got a little bit of harass coming from Cutie Pie. He is shredding out Zion Spartan right now. If he has the ward in that brush, he doesn't want to travel too far here. He's got to be very careful.
Oh no, they're chasing him down. He burns the flash, but he is still not near his team.
Cutie Pie goes down. He gets a little too antsy, trying to take down Zion Spartan. This could be Baron, but they may go straight down the mid.
15 kills now on Wiz Fusion. More kills than anyone has had in North American LCS this split in a game, and he is carrying for his team. The inhibitor had respawned, so Super Minions were not pushing down, but Dignitas is still trying to do something with Zed.
Golden Glue getting where he can. He's got the Guardian Angel so he can buy himself some time to be in that dangerous situation. Now Crumbs on his backside too, but Coast is going hard and heavy on that top turret right now. Going for the inhibitor as well right after Zion Spartan. He's going to try to do a little something here and
that's
really
a
take
dragon.
The time.
This could just
Dignitas
be the game. They're tanking this. There were two Dignitas people gone. They're just powering down these turrets. It's just Lee Sin in the base.
They still got Wiz Fusion. He doesn't have the Triforce, and it's not going to do a lot of damage to the turret, but they already have it between the four members. They're trying to back. We see that Zion Spartan is trying to stop Crumbs as well. The Nexus is so close to going down. Coast looks to take a game off of Dignitas. Santos in the four matches, and they do. 15 kills for Wiz Fusion. Coast Chance coming up for the first time all year here. Big monumental moment for them to take a game off of Dignitas here. They have struggled against every team above them in the standings this year. And to get this one in a 50-minute game, they held off the assault of Dignitas. They got it late enough. And hey, Wiz Fusion, he had his breakthrough game.
Such a fantastic game. Said in the beginning, the bot lane kind of needs to step up. And I think the whole team stepped up, and it showed across the board. Four kills, three kills, four. Then you got 15 kills.
Look at the smile on Fusion's face right there. And we talked a couple weeks ago about how great this guy was in solo queue when the pressure is not as high. And it's a mental switch, I feel like, in his brain right here. Coming into this game, Coast was locked into the sixth seed. So standings-wise and pressure-wise, this game was just kind of practice for him. And therefore, he performed. If he can just switch that in his head to make every game like that, he would be a force to be reckoned with in the LCS. He carried that game 15-2.
Making all the right moves. Even when you saw in that last fight, he kind of relentless pursued it in when Crumbs was dying and said, wait a minute. You know, everybody was readjusting. The communication from Coast on that was far better than Dignitas's. How many Tibbers alts did we see that weren't followed up on Dignitas's side of the jungle where they should feel comfortable?
Yeah, well, the interesting thing with Dignitas is they were kind of a composition revolving around finding catches.
Right.
But they kept kind of catching people and then getting collapsed on by a team fight for Coast. A lot of the Zion Spartan collapsed, a lot of initiations onto Daydreamin, who became too tanky on Leona. 0-8-13, but with the Rand wins completed, Negatron Cloak, Ruby Sightstone, so a lot of extra health sitting there on the support. And just strategically, the game stalled a little bit because of the early turret takes. And as we move forward, that's actually a pretty big advantage for Coast. They played TSM really close earlier today, and they came out on top of Dignitas. When they can kind of get to that mid-game with the game still close.
And Intendude having a tough start. Did not see a lot. The junglers, they don't get the best amount of levels in this one. So you're not going to see the man drops coming in. And his Pantheon definitely took a hit. It's 0-2, but now 1-2 coming out of this game with three plays. So showing up for himself, making strong plays. The man drops almost acted as kind of like a zoning tool. They may not have hit, but it definitely got Dig out of there when they needed it to.
Honestly, not the best game for Nintendo.
Yeah.
But I think the big story for this one for Coast is someone who is not a solar laner had a great game. Mm-hmm. Wiz Fusion and Daydreamin combined together.
That's a great point.
Were able to come forward. And if they can actually have diversified threat, it gives them a shot in the playoffs.
Well, Lucian doing very good things. Wiz Fusion was going back to Caitlyn quite a bit. We saw him trying to find that as something that they would use as the staple for Wiz to kind of win lane safely, not have to bully the lane and put a priority in his pocket and try to do something and push himself too far. But with this, it was amazing. Seeing that the 4.4 has been giving trouble to so many top teams, and now Coast is able to adapt, and it's where their weaker lanes are coming out on top.
Yeah, and it's going to be very interesting when we get into the playoffs, which will be 2 weeks from now, when we're actually going to be on the 4.5
match,
because even more has changed. It's going to be all about teams' ability to adapt to the present state of the game. It's part of competitive League of Legends, always adapting from patch to patch. That'll be real interesting.
And it is. Remember to send us your favorite highlights of today by tweeting at LOL Esports and use the hashtag LCS Big Plays. But for now, we're going to send it over to Freak for a firsthand account of Coast's big win.
Thank you very much, Riff. What's up, guys? We're joined by Wiz Fusion and Zion Spartan from Team Coast. Guys, that game was pretty crazy, very hectic. We'll start with your thoughts coming into the match, facing Dignitas. They still have much to play for. You're locked into sixth. How are you feeling coming into the game?
I mean, we weren't, we were taking it seriously, but we knew it wasn't really going to matter in the end. So we, we just came into it and just felt really confident, actually, and just played our best and didn't really, like, we didn't really feel scared at all, I guess.
Yeah, actually, Jat made a comment while casting, actually, that now that the pressure was off, you seem to step up a lot better. We know you do really, really well in solo queue. This was like a big breakout game for you. Was the lack of pressure helping you?
Yeah, I think so. I don't know. Like, recently in scrims, like, I tried to play a lot more aggressive because I knew that I played, like, more passive or, like, I was just afraid to die most of the time. So, I don't know. I guess I was trying to do it, honestly, all this LCS Super Week. I tried to do that, but, yeah, I guess I brought it out this game.
Yeah, it worked out really well. So, Zion, I want to talk to you a little bit. They banned your Jax this game. Of course, you didn't get to play it against TSM. I want to actually get your thoughts on just that game real quick, your sort of split-push Jax game, and like sort of what it's like when you're like, I have to like 1v2 all the time, like you're diving and making all these plays. Like, how close were you to like taking the game out by yourself?
Well, I could say one thing. There's times when I love top lane, and there's times when I hate top lane. I'm playing Renekton Shyvana, and I'm like, okay, guys, I'm just going to like build full tank items and sit in their team. But when I'm playing things like Jax, I'm just like, this is why I love playing top lane. This is why I pick this lane out of all the lanes, all the 1v2s and all that. Being level 1 until 5 minutes, it's okay if I can play a split pusher like Jax. And it's just really, really fun to just go in there and just not care. I just like dive, just like I can 1v2, I can 1v3, just like bring all of them, but then like the tower kills me half the time and I just like end up trading one for one. But it's really nice to have that pressure on a split pusher like Jax, and it's really what made me love League of Legends, like being that strong where you can actually like take on multiple enemies on a team.
Yeah, well, actually, we're seeing this style kind of overtake the LCS a little bit. Cruiser, first pick Lee Sin for the team, of course, taken away from you as well. How are you feeling about sort of facing against the top lane Lee Sin and seeing more top laners playing playmakers?
I think it's a good step forward. I think that a lot of the times the champions play top lane don't really take that much mechanical skill. Like Renekton, Shyvana, Mundo, like Shen, they're really not that hard to play mechanically. It's all about how you fit into the team on these champions. And where I shine is the champions that actually take mechanical difficulty. And where the other top laners often like outperform me is in these other aspects of playing the more team-based games. So I think that it's really good that the other top laners are also trying to play these top laners that require more mechanical skill, and they're performing well on them. So I'm looking forward to more of those types of champions being played in top lane, and I hope it sort of changes towards that.
Do you have any ideas on what's the next sleeper OP top laner after Jax and Lee Sin kind of settle out?
Yeah, you guys are going to see in playoffs, and it's going to be some fun matches. Just remember Spring Split 2013, guys, bringing it back.
Is that Fizz?
No, not Fizz. The playoffs. Not the Spring Split. I went like 0-10 on Fizz. Not that game. Don't remind me about that.
Okay. The 2013 playoffs, the top two finish. Okay, so let's actually get ourselves into the game and talk about some of the things that happened. Of course, a big, huge Lucian game for you. Let's actually bring up the replay then of about 45-minute team fight. Your guys' bottom inhibitor, actually, if we can get that on your screen. I want you to walk me through how you win this battle here.
Oh, yeah. I think we were really looking to initiate onto them. As you see, we just tried to go at Corki. But in the end, they actually just started running away, and it was mainly towards the end of the fight where we actually started to clean up the kills. I think Zion goes a little bit too ham, and then we just turn on to them. Me and Shifter are looking to turn on them in a little bit. Like right here, this is where we're going to start to turn, just because we see that Crumbs has a GA popped. And it was actually kind of surprising that we won this team fight. But yeah, and then we just, I think after they used everything, we were just able to turn when they followed up. Me and Shifter are just going to turn a little bit.
You pretty much pushed him away.
Yeah, I just knew that I think I was strong enough because I had 6 items, so we just were able to turn on them after they used everything.
Yeah, when Ryze hits that 6 item point, it's just like, I'm an AP carry and I'm a tank. What are you guys going to do? And him and the 6 item AD carry could just clean up the rest of that fight. They kind of had like Lee Sin and Zed and Eve, kind of like a more early mid-game pick-focused comp.
Yeah.
And we kind of had that late game, so we knew, hey guys, it's okay if we get a little bit behind. We got the better late game. But unfortunately, that game ended in the most anticlimactic way. But it was still a pretty good game. It could have been played a lot smoother by both sides, but yeah. Glad we were able to pick up the win.
Well, you mentioned the way the game ended, actually. That's our second replay here, where I don't know if you intentionally baited QtPie to follow you, but he does that anyway. We can get that replay up on the screen. QtPie just dives you. What is this one?
I'm just like, guys, all right, I'm going to bait QtPie. I got this perfect strategy planned out, so I'm just going to stand here. He's going to go on me. He just wants to go on that 6 item tank. No. I was just walking, like, oh, wait, guys, I'm going up instead of down. I don't know what I'm doing. I shouldn't be splitting away from the team. I'm, like, almost dead, and then I go into fog, and then he, like, keeps chasing me. But then what he doesn't realize is my ult is back up, and then we have the rest of our team there, so WizFusion's just able to go in there, pick him up with the culling, and then we're just like, is the game about to end this way? Let's go finish this game right now. It's like, even though we're down like a lot of gold, it's just like their AD carry just got caught out. And that's the end of the game when it gets to that late. And we were just surprised that he would tunnel that hard on a tank. But I was really lucky I didn't end up dying there, because it could have very well been the other way around. And that's what makes the difference between somebody look really bad and really good. If he had killed me, I would have looked like the bad player. That's like, what's Zion doing? He's running up. But My team was able to follow up in time, and they ended up making me look like the savior that baited PewDiePie really hard. So I'm really glad it turned out that way.
The intentional move. You just got to claim that it was all your own. Yeah. PewDiePie going to double lift school today, apparently. So let's talk about then you're running in a playoff. So you know you're sixth seed. You know CLG's third. I want to talk to you about this first round matchup. Best of three. What are your thoughts?
I mean, I think we're just going to take it like any other match. Obviously, CLG has been looking really strong lately. Mm-hmm. We're just going to practice and really prep for the new patch. I think that's what's going to be the most important thing. It's just like adapting really quickly. We're seeing like new picks come out almost every single week now.
Yeah.
Like Zed has actually been really popular as of late. Karma too, Corki.
Yeah.
So I think it's just adapting really quickly is going to be most important.
So actually, I want to press you on those. As a duo laner, Karma, you actually say Karma and Corki have been very popular. What's your read on both these two champions?
I think the fact that Corki, I mean, okay, I think Corki has always been good ever since they buffed him, but he lacked in lane phase. Mm-hmm. And I don't think he's really bad at it, but he just has, like, compared to Lucian or maybe Caitlyn, it's just weaker. But when you start to hit that level, like a level 11 ultimate or level 16, it's... He does an absurd amount of damage because it's like 60% of your bonus AD or 60% of your AD, and then if you have Bloodthirster, you're just starting to do a ton of damage through rockets. And the fact that it's mixed damage is also really important.
Yeah, and then Karma?
A lane bully, I think, is like the most important thing. So you have someone who's not as good in lane with a lane bully, I think it just meshes well with each other.
Okay, so then one more question then for you guys, final one. We've noticed a lot of 2-on-1 lane swaps been happening recently, especially with you guys, your last two games, you go for 2-on-1s. Why is this happening?
I think it's kind of just the way top lane currently is. It's just like, hey guys, I'm going to be level 1 until 5 minutes this game because everybody's running teleport and nobody wants to lane against the Renekton with Ignite. Or if you know you have the bad matchup, it's just like, why lane against someone I can run teleport in 2v1? So it's just kind of like being run every game. With teleport being buffed, it's actually a really strong summoner spell, especially during the early game because the cooldown's reduced to like 3 minutes if you use it on a tower. So not only is it good for laning, it's probably the summoner spell that scales the most into the late game because of how strong it is to have one person in the bottom side of the map who can be on the other side of the map in just 4 seconds. So it's kind of like I think the biggest thing is like the teleport being buffed, essentially.
And interesting that if you actually went with the Ignite Jax game and managed to get a bunch of kills that way, I like that. You had the summoner spell advantage and used it. It was fun.
I'm like, guys, I like getting kills on Jax. I'm going to run Ignite. I hope you guys don't mind. I'm not going to be able to teleport into fights, though. So, sorry, I'm going to be split pushing the whole game. It's fine.
Ignore team, acquire KDA.
Good.
Yeah. I like it. All right, guys, well, of course, congratulations on the win. We'll see you tomorrow. Thanks very much for your time. We're going to have 2 more LCS games plus the Challenger quarterfinals. Keep your browser where it is right now. We've got more LCS coming your way. When we come back, CLG takes the Rift against Evil Geniuses, so don't go anywhere.
Whoa, Kiwi could get very close into the fight. The health bar, the Golden Glue, and Kiwi go down very fast. Golden Glue is able to get himself back out to that initial shadow once again. Very good at that. And they are microing in and out, but Shifter's able to find one onto Cruiser. The back and forth leaves it at a 3-for-1 so far. And Coast is using the walls of their base to bolt.